Namaskar. Welcome to this session. We are considering Sampragnyata Samadhi. And in the last session, I told you about the process of Sampragnyata Samadhi based on Samapatti Sutras, because Samapatti topic describes the psychology, mindology, chittology of Samadhi. So, yogi embarks upon his internal antaranga sadhana, dharna, dhyan, samadhi practices by pranayama. There is no bypass to it. Unexceptionally, it is pranayama. Then, as I told you, sthula pranayama, sukshma pranayama, then pranavatma pranayama, soham sadhana, what is called as soham sadhana, of which we are aware, common man is aware of it in adhyatma. And then the om of soham becomes like a blackboard on which the teachers in schools and colleges write on the blackboard. So vitarka, vichara, aananda, asmita, samadhi, they appear on omified chitta. From pranava, from om, comes up the samadhi process of a yogi. Om is the master key of any samadhi, every samadhi, and samadhi all the time. So that's an aspect of mysticism of which we should be aware. So as common man might think that the yogi concentrates on something on which he wants to have samadhi, and then samadhi occurs. So that is very, very naive to be thinking that way. Because basically the pranayama, which culminates into dharna suchi yogyata manasaha, that means yogi becomes totally desireless, and the vasikara sagnya vairagya, which he has earned, surfaces, actualizes, and therefore there will be drushtani shravaka vishaya vitrushna. Therefore there cannot be any thirst. Yogi's mind is cosmicalized, and in the cosmicalized mind appears the object of samadhi. Like dream objects appear in the mind which is gone to sleep, which is in dormant state of consciousness. It is only in dormancy that dream experiences come up. So the divinity actually gives the subject matter of samadhi, substrate of samadhi, support of samadhi, and then what occurs is dharana, dhyan, samadhi for a yogi. So yogi doesn't decide that I should have samadhi on this and that, and doesn't go into it by closing the eyes. So that is how the process we had seen earlier. Then, as I said, there is all invariably a japa. Japa is the means of samadhi, which is also implied by Patanjali. When we come to Ishvara topic, then that is quite expressed there. So it could be pranava or any other name of Ishvara. Ishvara has several names. Pranava is one of the such names, and most exalted, most profound denotation of Ishvara. So, yatha vibhada dhyana dva is the process out of chitta parikarma which yogi selects And then that is name of his personal deity, could be Rama, Krishna, Narasimha, Shiva, Shakti, Ganesha, Dattatreya, etc. And the mind is cosmicalized. And Samadhi, object appears in such a mind. And then dharna, dhyana, samadhi take place in such a mind. So the point to be noted at the samadhi support is intuitively, mystically appearing on the mind and not under the whim of a yogi. So that was a process. And then we said we should be trying to know what is this Sampragnyata Samadhi. Sampragnyata, Sampragnana. Sampragnana is always with reference to four categories as expressly mentioned by Patanjali. And therefore he says vitarkanugata, vicharanugata, aanandanugata, asmitanugata. Four kinds of Sampragnyat Samadhis are there. As the sutra is, vitarka vichara ananda asmita rupanugamat Sampragnyataha. So these are the four supports. And again, the mysticism should be understood here. That these are not four classes, that one of the classes will come up as a samadhi object in the mind. This is the process, vitarka, then vichara, and then ananda, and then asmita. It is possible that it will start with vitarka and end with vitarka. If it has to be vichara, then it will start with vitarka, go to vichara, and end with vichara. If it is ananda, it will start with vitarka and it will go to vichara and then will end in ananda. If it is asmita, then it will go through vitarka, vichara, ananda, asmita. So, this is how the process is in the mysticism. It is not that there are four classes, either it is vitarka anugata or vichara anugata or ananda anugata or asmita anugata. But it is vitarkanugata is number one. The second one is vitarkanugata and vicharanugata. Vicharanugata en route vitarkanugata. If it is anandanugata, it will be en route vitarkanugata vicharanugata. If it is asmitanugata, it will be en route vitarkanugata vicharanugata anandanugata. This is the process. And we saw the meaning of anugamanam. Anugamanam means the chitta comes under the spell of these samadhi supports. So these are samadhi supports, either 1 or 1 plus 2 or 1 plus 2 plus 3 or 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So if it is graduating, it will go towards vichara and then ananda and then asmita, anugata. So anugata means getting under the spell. The chitta comes under the spell. Like in hypnotic spell, it happens that one is under the spell of magician or hypnotizer, and the hypnotized is totally under the spell, loses the individual psyche and therefore adheres to psyche of the hypnotizer. So anugamat is wonderful word that has been introduced by Patanjali. It is to be understood from the verb anugamanam. Anugamanam means to follow under a spell, to get under the spell so that you lose your identity and then you go by the will and wish and whim of the person who is being followed. So, now what are these supports? What is vitarka? It's a technical term. One should not look into dictionary and try to arrive at the meaning of the word philologically. It is a technical term. The vitarka means the grossest metaphysical supports. If you recall, I said samadhis are always having as support something that is metaphysical. And vitarka means the grossest category in metaphysical supports. So vitarka means there are 16 supports, metaphysical 16 supports. What are these 16 supports? Panchamahabhutas, Dashendriyas, plus Ekadashendriya mind. So 5 plus 10 plus 1, 16 supports. On little metaphysical plane, not on phenomenal plane and temporal plane, but little beyond. If you want, when the yogi needs the realization of Panchamahabhutas, it is not just knowledge and information about Panchamahabhutas that we have, that we can have. With the help of Agama, we will know what is Prithvi Mata Mahabhuta, and then what is Ap, Tej, Vayu, Akash Mahabhuta, their characteristics, their functions, their manifestations, etc. So we can have knowledge of these principles metaphysically, so also senses. We have Ekadasha Indriyas, 10 senses, 10 Karmendriya, Gnanendriyas, and then Ekadasha Manam, Manas. We have the information about it. It's not realization. None of us have realized our own mind. None of us have realized the 10 cognitive cognitive organs. We have them. We use them. We know them. We have not realized. So, now if you analyze here, there'll be grahya category, grahana category, and grahitru category. That's why I told you about Samapatti Sutra there. Kshina vruttehe abhijatase vamanehe grahita grahana grahyeshu tatsa tadanjanata samapatti. So the samapatti is with regards to three categories, grahitru, grahana, grahya. So here you can see that in vitarka you have this grahitru, grahana, grahya. How are those? What are the grahyas? Grahyas are panchamahabhutas. What are grahitrus? Are the 10 cognitive cognitive organs? They are instruments through which we get experiences, we get knowledge, etc. 5 cognitive organs, 5 cognitive organs. So they are grahana category. And the grahitru is subjective entity of manas. So the vitarkanugata will be having again these subdivisions, that it will be revelation of these 16 categories which are comprised of grahitu, grahana, grahya. And then there are these 16. Then vichara samapatti pertains to 6. Those are tanmatra, 5 tanmatra and asmita tattva. So again you will find that it is circumscribing grahitru, grahana, grahya. Because the pancha tanmatras are infra-atomic structure of elements. That means grahya. The pancha tanmatras are shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha tanmatra. So the grahana aspect of five cognitive objects are also considered here. Shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, vishayas. And then asmita. Asmita is a precursor of mind. So that is grahitru. So if Sampragnya Samadhi is going to commence, it will commence from vitarkanugata. And then if the qualification is there, the yogi will go into the second stage of it. Not the second class of it, second stage of it. So vitarkanugata will go into vicharanugata. Therefore, there will be more higher revelations of six principles. Pancha tadmatra and asmita. So 16 plus 6. 22 Sankhya principles are here that you can be counting. And then, of course, the grahitru is also coming in, grahana is also coming in. Because the recourse has been already taken to vitarkanugata. And if there is a qualification for the next stage of Sampragnata, it will be vicharanugata. So, subjective entity too is already included in vitarkanugata. And therefore, furthermore, insight into grahitu aspects will be had. And we know that the self is described as sat chidananda. Sat chidananda. Sat means true, existing, existent. Chit means conscious, sentient. And ananda means bliss. So this is the nature of the subjective principle. That it is sat chidananda rupam. Sat is there, chit is there, ananda is there. And therefore, when it goes closer to it, the core principle, then comes aanandanugata samapatti. Because bliss is the nature. Apart from the sat and then chit. So, in mysticism and adhyatma, we are told about satchidananda rupam. Satchidananda rupa of the self. The self principle. And therefore, the aanandanugata will be coming as the third stage of it. And then asmita. Asmita means just chit. And sat chit. So, that is how the sutra is brought in this sequential order of vitarkanugata, vicharanugata, aanandanugata, asmitanugata. So all those 25 principles are included. And of course, the 26th principle, which is Ishvara, is the sarvantaryami, antaryami of self. And therefore, that too is circumscribed. All the 26 principles of Sankhya are circumscribed in Sampragnyata Samadhi. So, grahitru grahana grahya. Also, you can see that there are all the 26 principles. And so also in Sampragnyata Samadhi, you will have all the 26 principles of Sankhya. The 24 of Prakriti, the 25th, the Purusha, and the 26th, the Antaryami Ishvara. So, this is how the sutra is. And these revelations only take place in Samadhi. There is no cerebral process to understand 16 principles, realize them, reveal them. and then six principles of subtler category, and then ananda principle, and then asmita principle. We will have only information of it. We might have little experience of it, but not the intuitive mystic experience, samadhi, sakshatkara. These are all subject matters of samadhi sakshatkara. You don't have to have samadhi sakshatkara for tangible objects, sensory objects. But in the realm of metaphysics, you need samadhi sakshatkara where there is transformation. You need to become. You need to become these principles to realize those principles in a samadhi process. It is not an objective knowledge of these principles of Sankhya which are mentioned in samadhi. Here there is transformation, there is becoming. And for becoming, samadhi is only the process. You can't cerebrally become, you will only cerebrally know. You won't empirically become, you will only empirically know. You will have information or knowledge. They will remain as objects of your knowledge. So, for us, the 26 principles of Sankhya are objects of knowledge. We try to know them. We will know them. And that's all. And nothing beyond. But in Samadhi, there is transformation and becoming. If you recall, in the earlier sessions, I told you about it. So, yogi who is qualified for Samadhi will be getting the Sampragnata Samadhi. Now, this Sampragnata Samadhi has these four stages and they spiral out. It is a spiral process. There is no interruption. There is no bypass. There is no bypass to vitarka, vichara, ananda if it is to be asmita. There is no bypass to vitarka, vichara if it is to be ananda. And there is no bypass for vichara if it is to be bypass to vitarka if it is to be vichara. So they understand the pervasiveness and they are spiraling out. So these are not five classes, these are spiral stages. Vitarka, vitarka vichara ananda, vitarka vichara ananda asmita. So they spiral out. This should be understood here as an information so that we will not be misled. So let's try to go into a little bit of Vyasa's comment. Then we will have a little realization of the process here objectively. So, Sampragnyat Samadhi is defined as Vitarka, Vichara, Ananda, Asmita related spells. And the effective Chitta Vritti Nirodha is Sampragnyat Samadhi. Because you will realize that in Vichara, the vitarka is restrained. In ananda, vitarka, vichara are restrained. And in asmita, vitarka, vichara, ananda are restrained. Because one goes past those stages. And that is why it is called samadhi. There is restraint and then it is called sampragnyat samadhi. So, vitarkaha chittasya alambane sthul abhogaha. The support of vitarka anugata samadhi are gross supports for chitta. Then in sukshma, the sukshma supports are in vichara. Sukshmo vicharaha anandho ladaha ekatmika samvit asmita. This is what Vyasa puts in a briefest statement, which I elaborated so far for you. So, these are alambanas, these are supports. Supports for chitta. And when it is complete transformation, it is called vitarka samadhi with regards to gross supports, which I told you there are 16. Then when it is complete transformation with regards to subtle supports, which are 6, then it is called vichara samadhi. And then complete or accomplishment in ananda, which is our essential condition, core condition, ananda, because we are sat chit ananda. So that ananda, complete or completion in bliss transformation is ananda. And then purusha buddhi ekatmata, totally going away, is asmita. And therefore it is called vitarkanugata, vicharanugata, aanandanugata, asmitanugata. For you to understand under the spell of vitarka category, then under the spell of vichara category, under the spell of ananda category, and under the spell of asmita category. Tatra prathama chatushtyanugata savitarkaha. So the first one in the body of four is called vitarkanugata. So it is called savitarka, savitarka, with vitarka. Dvitiyo vitarka vikalaha. As I told you that there is a restraint. You go past vitarka to embark upon vichara. You have to go through vitarka and then proceed further for vichara. So vitarka will be restrained. Vitarka will be dropped out. So dhityo vitarka vikalpaha, vikalaha. Vikalaha means the stage given up. Savichara, that is savichara. And then tritiyo vichara vikalaha, sanandaha. The third one is vichara vikala, that means vitarka vichara vikala. That is sananda. And chaturtaha tad vikalo asmita. The fourth is asmita, which is vitarka vichara ananda vikala. That means stages gone past, stages left behind. The stages fall off. So this is how the samadhi journey is. Like, you know, in the space ship. Spaceship, the stages which are burnt out, they fall off. They fall off the main body. So similarly, in the journey of samadhi, these stages fall off. First, the vitarka stage falls off. Then vichara 2 falls off. And then ananda 2 falls off. And then asmita will be culminative phase. It is not necessary that every time you should reach asmitanugata sampragnyat samadhi. The samadhi might terminate at vitarkanugata. If that is all the qualification and that is what the Bhagwan intends, that is the Bhagwad Echha, that is the desire of divinity, that you should only realize vitarka, then with vitarka the samadhi will be revoked. If the divinity wishes that you should also circumscribe vichara, then vitarka vichara will be the journey and it will be revoked. For ananda samadhi, vitarka vichara ananda will be part of the journey and then it will be revoked. And in case it is wished by divinity antaryami that you must have asmita anugata, then it will be vitarka vichara ananda. All the three stages, it will spiral out into the subsequent stages. And therefore, there is a usage that it is savitarka samadhi, savichara samadhi, sananda samadhi, or sasmita samadhi. But you should know that how the nirodha is there as one proceeds in the channel of Sampragnata Samadhi. And therefore, these are all Salambana Samadhyaha. Sarva ete Salambanaha Samadhyaha is the last statement of Vyasa in the commentary. Therefore, these are all called Salambana Samadhis because there is support. there is support of the nature of vitarka, or there is support of the nature of vitarka and vichara, or there is support of the nature of vitarka, vichara, ananda, or there is a support of the nature of vitarka, vichara, ananda, asmita. Therefore, these are all sabija samadhis, seeded samadhis, salambana samadhis. So, sampragnyat samadhi is said to be salambana samadhi. So, vitarka, vichara, ananda, asmita are the stages of sampragnyat samadhi. And this asmitanugata samadhi will give that viveka khyati to the yogi. Because yogi is looking for viveka khyati. And this viveka khyati is outcome, consequence of last of the sampragnyat samadhis. Asmitanugata sampragnyat samadhi is buddhi, purusha, union will be deciphered, and then it will be viveka khyati, the dawn of viveka khyati. Now, viveka khyati, if it is a dawn of viveka khyati, it is a means of what? It is means of kaivalya when it is aviplava. When it is full-fledged viveka khyati, that is the means of kaivalya in ethico-religious system of Patanjali. So, when vichara samadhi is, this asmita samadhi is had, do you mean to say that the samadhi realm is over? Samadhi journey is over? Because that is the terminal. No, that is terminal condition of sampragnyata samadhi. Now, if the yogi is wished to be going beyond and qualified and wished by divinity to be going beyond, then the next samadhi will also come in. And that is asampragnyata samadhi. Asampragnyata, not sampragnyata. Transcendence of sampragnyata. Therefore, it is asampragnyata samadhi. Asampragnyata samadhi is not a class. It is asampragnyata samadhi. There is a prefix by way of a. Like you have prefix to words, say, logic or logical. Prefix a-logical. That means transcending logic. Moral, amoral means transcending moral. Morality, amorality means it's not immorality. Amorality means transcending morality. That prefix a is for transcendence and not for negative. So that is why the next is asampragnyata samadhi. And that is the angi samadhi. Sampragnyat is Anga Samadhi. Because Patanjali has mentioned eight limbs of yoga where he includes Samadhi. Yamaniyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadha, Yoho, Ashtavangani. So Samadhi is also a limb of yoga. Then what is the whole yoga? Whole yoga is Asampragnyata Samadhi. That is why it is called Angi Yoga. So there is Anga Yoga and Angi Yoga. Limb of yoga and the whole of yoga. Limbs of yoga and the whole of yoga. We are made up of limbs. All the limbs put together, we get our identity. So, there comes Asampragnyata Yoga, Asampragnyata Samadhi, which is the second samadhi. Because Patanjali is said to have mentioned two samadhis, sampragnyata and asampragnyata. We have seen the meaning of sampragnyata. It is sampragnana. It is jnana by transformation, jnana by becoming. You become, and then understand when you become, there is no need to know yourself. Like, we are ourselves, therefore we don't feel the need to know ourselves. And that's why materialistic people never have this problem that I should know myself. Because they say, I am myself, and I am myself, why should I be knowing? It is only the spiritual realm that one realizes that I need to know myself. And therefore we are told a kind of piece of instruction, know thyself. Non-spiritual person never thinks that there is a problem. And never thinks that there is ignorance. Because I am myself, so where is the question of knowing myself? But if you are little spiritually inclined, you will realize there is much to know about oneself. And we hardly know about ourselves. If we know it, it is all perversely knowing it. Not only insufficiently knowing it or wrongly knowing it, but perversely knowing it. So Adhyatma tells us about this fact, and therefore in Adhyatma, this kind of piece of instruction comes, know thyself. So, here is a pursuit for this process to be accomplished. Know thyself. It will be accomplished in asampragnyata samadhi. So now, we reach the realm of asampragnyata samadhi, which is after sampragnyata. It is not that sometimes yogi has Sampragnyat Samadhi and then sometimes Asampragnyat Samadhi. For Asampragnyat Samadhi to be happening, the spiraling out will land into Asampragnyat. The spiraling has to be there. Spiraling process has to be there. So it will commence. Even for Asampragnyat Samadhi, it will commence from vitarkanugata, vicharanugata, aanandanugata, asmitanugata and then beyond. So it is not that it is not to be understood as second class of samadhi. It is culmination of sampragnyat samadhi, provided one has resources, one is qualified, one has empowerment, and for one, the antaryami has the wish that the yogi should go beyond. We have to go through vitarkanugata, vicharanugata, aanandanugata, asmitanugata to land into realm of asampragnyat samadhi. That is asampragnyata samadhi. Now that is defined in the very next sutra. But then we understood that we have not really completely considered vairagya. Something was to be considered, and if you recall that in vitarkanugata, we gave up vitarkanugata for vicharanugata. So there was restraint process. Vitarka restraint, then vitarka vichara restraint, then vitarka vichara ananda restraint, then vitarka vichara ananda asmita restraint. So we came across this. Now in case yogi is qualified, then vitarka will be restrained, vichara will be restrained, ananda will be restrained, asmita will be restrained, and asampragnyat samadhi will come in. So that is the asampragnyat samadhi. Now, what is given up for asampragnyat samadhi? See, in asmitanugata samadhi, I told you that yogi gets viveka khyati. Yogi gets viveka khyati. And then, when that too is restrained, that means that too is given up. Now that was really cherished by yogi in his sadhana process, that viveka khyati was sought after. Now when that is attained, then that too is given up. When that too is given up, then asampragnyat samadhi comes up. When that too is given up, that is para vairagya. So here comes the last stage of vairagya. Once one is gone past asmitanugata samadhi or is about to go past asmitanugata samadhi, then the viveka khyati has to be restrained. That is the last vritti of a yogi. yogi is restraining vrittis. In the process of yoga, the vrittis are getting restrained. First, vitarka class is restrained, then vichara class is restrained, then ananda class is restrained, then asmita class is restrained. When asmita class is restrained, that is the final vritti. Sattva purusha arnita khyati, viveka khyati, this is called final vritti, last vritti. There is no vritti thereafter. Now that too is restrained, therefore it is called paravairagya. And therefore, what is the nature of paravairagya? Param drushtva nivartante was the principle so far considered during our vairagya delineation. But then tat param, higher to that, what is it? Purushakhyatehe gunavaitrushnyam. Tatparam, higher to that, is giving up viveka khyati, which is nothing but exalted sattva guna. So that too is given up. Now we are all trying to collect sattva guna. We are not trying to reject sattva guna in our process of yoga. We are trying to accept, collect as much as comes our way. We want to collect, we want to grab on it. We want to pounce on sattva guna and try to collect as much as it comes. Nowhere we are coming to a state that we are giving up. But yogi in asmitanugata samadhi will be giving up that too for asampragnyat samadhi to set in. And when that last vritti, final vritti, culminative vritti is given up, it is complete restraint, total restraint. Sarvavritti nirodha. And when it is sarvavritti nirodha, it is asampragnyata samadhi. And therefore, that is the vairagya there. When what all throughout the life and lives was cherished, was sought after, and there was thirst for sattva guna. We all must have a thirst for sattva guna, endless thirst for sattva guna. We have to amass it, we have to collect it, we have to gather it, we have to store it, we have to preserve it. But when it is asmitanugata samadhi, that too is restrained, that too is given up, that is paravairagya. So tat param purushakhyate he guna vaitrushnyam. Higher than that is when purushakhyati is taking place, self-realization is taking place, by which and because of which the guna vaitrushnya, the sattva guna, the thirst for sattva guna also is ended. Therefore it is called paravaitrushnya, paravaitrushna, that is paravairagya. So here, at this stage, I am able to culminate on vairagya topic with the mention of asampragnyat samadhi coming up, because in asampragnyat samadhi it is sarvavritti nirodha. In sampragnyat samadhi it is not sarvavritti nirodha. In our yoga it is not sarvavritti nirodha. In our yoga it is rajatama vritti nirodha. We will be trying to restrain our rajatama vritti in our yoga. Then yogi, by that, has huge support of sattva guna. And then, that's how sampragnyat samadhi takes place with that backing of sattva guna, resources of sattva guna. But when sampragnyat samadhi is also coming to culminative phase, that viveka khyati is had. When the viveka khyati is had, that's the last chitta vritti. There is no chitta vritti beyond it. This also should be understood here. There is no next chitta vritti after viveka khyati or sattva purusha anita khyati. That's the last vritti possible in chitta. When that too is given up by purusha sakshatkara of asampragnyat samadhi, then that is paravairagya. So that is the paravairagya, and that is the gateway for us to understand asampragnyata samadhi. So that we will see in our next session. So today we have covered entire Sampragnyat Samadhi, which I have four stages. And coming to asmitanugata Samadhi, we found a way, like when you sight a horizon, and when you reach that point, the horizon extends. Similarly, the horizon extends, and that horizon is called Asampragnata Samadhi. And when that is coming up, there is para vairagya, supreme vairagya. So with that, we have also concluded the topic of Sampragnyat Samadhi, very introductory information about it. Now, in the next session, we'll be going for Asampragnyata Samadhi. So, namaskar all of you.